Let's move to the next part. And the next part is installing Ansible. So to install Ansible, whether you're on a Mac, Windows, or Linux, the first path is you can install Ansible via pip. And of course, if you have Python installed on your machine, you can install Ansible via pip. A second option is for anyone with Linux. Even on Windows, that's what we're going to do. We're going to install Ansible via WSL, and I'm going to install it on Ubuntu. So if you're on a Mac, Windows, and you can install a virtual environment and use that and install Ansible. So there are lots of ways you can get a virtual environment on your system. You can use VirtualBox and install a virtual machine. You can use Vagrant, and I'm going to use Vagrant with Windows as my managed nodes. So of course, I would love to do this tutorial on Linux, but I prefer to use Camtasia to record my videos. I just wanted to answer that in this video. Why, when I'm doing an initial server setup for a Linux system, I use Windows to record sometimes. And that's because of Camtasia. I just prefer to record and edit with Camtasia. Since I'm on Windows, I'm going to install Ubuntu on WSL. If you're on Windows, that's the same path you should take because Ansible doesn't run natively on Windows. If you're on Linux, any Linux distribution, it doesn't matter. You can install Ansible via the package manager, or you can install Python and then install Ansible. So in this case, let's go to WSL. If your WSL is not enabled, just make sure you enable it. You can just do a Google search for how to enable WSL on Windows. It's not a big process nowadays. If you're using the latest updated Windows, then it's not a difficult process. In my case, WSL is already installed. I don't know if I've installed Ubuntu yet because I want to use Ubuntu. I'll just go to the App Store, Windows, Microsoft Store, and I will search for Ubuntu. Let's just do a search and see all the options which are here. We have Ubuntu. Yeah, I will go with 2204. Just click on it. Click on get. So I have WSL already turned on. So let it download, and then I'm just going to open it like a normal app. And we're going to see what we can do next. So for you to enable WSL on Windows, make sure that virtualization is enabled on your Windows, on your BIOS, I mean. So you can check for virtualization. I'm here on Windows 10. If you go to the task manager, and you look at, is it performance? You look somewhere here, you'll see virtualization enabled. Virtualization enabled. If this is not enabled, you need to go into your BIOS and then enable it. Just Google how to do it for your motherboard, for your specific computer. This needs to be enabled before you can work with WSL successfully. So I'm just going to wait for this to finish downloading, and then we're going to continue after this. Is the installation complete? It says open. Let me open and see if it is complete. Enter a new Unix username. So this is like installing Ubuntu. So just give it a username. And then give it a password. All right, so there we go. We have a new Ubuntu installation on our Windows. For good usability, let me just increase the font. Let's try 24. There we go. That should be much better. Control L to clear the screen. And then we can continue on from here. So now we have Ubuntu. So let's just see if there are any updates. I'm going to do apt update. Could not lock the file, so I need sudo dash dash. So dash dash is like just rerun what was run last. So this is, instead of retyping the command again, you can just do that and it's going to replace it to the last command we ran. While this is happening, let's come back here. And since I'm on Ubuntu, as I said, there are two ways in which you can install Ansible. The first way, you can use the package manager, you can just do sudo apt install and you'll see that there's an Ansible that will be installed. But the reason why we do this is so that you can get the latest version of Ansible. You can also install it via pip if you have Python installed. And to be specific, install Python 3 because that's what is recent. So install Python 3 and then install pip and then install Ansible. If you don't know how to install pip, there are lots of tutorials online. It is a very simple process. So I will not cover that. Control L to clear the screen. So you can see we have 87 packages can be upgraded, but I'm not going to do that now. Control L to clear the screen. So if I do, what I'm telling you is, even if you don't add the PPA, if I do apt search Ansible, apt search Ansible, you can see that there is an Ansible version 2.10 and Ansible core is a 2.12, but currently the Ansible core that is available is 2.12, 2.15. So you can see this is really not the latest. That's why we add the PPA. Let me just copy this again. So sudo apt update, sudo apt install software properties. I don't know that these are already installed, but I'm just going to do it again. They're probably not installed already. So I'm just going to install apt software properties common. And then we're going to add the repository for Ansible PPA. So that just gives us the PPA with the latest Ansible, with the latest Ansible package. So if I run that, it's going to run the apt update and then it's going to install this application. This is going to install this package. And then after that, it's going to add the repository from this PPA of Ansible. Press enter to accept. So it's installing that. Now the PPA has been added. Now let's try and do apt search Ansible again. Let's see if the version is different. So you can see here we are getting 8. In the previous one, Ansible core was 2.12, now it's 2.15. So you can clearly see why you should add the PPA, because it's going to give you the latest version of Ansible core and Ansible. So Ansible core is the original Ansible. That is the Ansible brain. It has everything with Ansible. It has the inner workings of Ansible. Now, Ansible is a compilation of plugins, modules, basically almost everything you'll need to run any environment. You need to automate any environment. That's why you install Ansible. It contains Ansible core. So this is the inner working of Ansible, but Ansible comes with Ansible inner core and a bunch of other plugins and modules that are going to be instrumental in your automation. So once we do this, once we know that we've added the PPA, we do install Ansible. So if you want to follow along with me in this setup, if you are not on Windows, what you can do is, so sudo apt install Ansible will install Ansible. What you can do is just create a virtual environment and then install Ubuntu. You can use VirtualBox if that's the one you want to use. Install VirtualBox. If you're on Windows, you don't need any of that. All you need is WSL. Enable WSL, install Ubuntu, and that's it. So now let's just wait for Ansible to install. And we're going to see the version of Ansible that is installed. So if you prefer to go with the Ansible pip route, there are certain things that will be different. Just a location of certain files, but that is really not important because most of the files we're going to use, we're going to create them. For example, the host file, that is the inventory file. We're going to create that. There's a default place for that. But when we get to that point, I'm going to tell you more about it. For now, we just know that Ansible is installed. We can check the Ansible version. All right, there we go. Ansible is now installed in Ubuntu 22.04. And if we do Ansible, I think I copied it. Right click and it will paste on WSL. Our Ansible core is 2.15. So there we go. We have Ansible installed successfully and it's telling us Python. We're using Python version 3. Jinja, this is a templating engine that is used in Ansible. So this is a templating engine. It's used in even Django. If you install Ansible via Python, some of these locations are going to be different. especially the executable location, will be inside of Python if you install it via pip. This has been kind of a long video, slightly long video, but sometimes in tech, it's very important to understand the theory of things and why we do what we do. In this case, for example, you saw why we add the PPA and also other ways of installing it, even though we only installed it in WSL. So I did go through a few theoretical things that I know will help you understand something. If you had questions about why we do this, we do that, maybe some of those questions were answered in this video. So that's how to install Ansible. Let's just confirm what we're going to do in the next part. We're going to talk about Ansible configuration. So that's the next part, Ansible configuration.